never gonna get it after you shoot that. 100% of that. The closer you get it, the better. That's gonna keep you even. And the more you put on.
Hey, this is Don from Airbrush the Magazine, airbrushthemagazine.com. Go and subscribe, help support us visiting these Airbrush events. We've been to Airbrush Circus twice, been to Phoenix with Tim Lowry. Now we're at Tamco Takeover 2. This is Gouch Customs and Adam.
I think so, because maybe you like it. I don't like it. Now, somebody that's way, like, really experienced, like me and Adam, I use it all day, every day. I'm super used to it. maybe as a beginner, it might be a little tougher to control. But for me, like, once this is on there, it doesn't, like, want to lift up or pull right there. So. That vinyl's so stretchy. Yeah. Exactly. What kind of a mood I'm in?
Can't be afraid to take it off and start over.
It depends. Oh, absolutely. One of those things, okay, I tell everybody, like, this pinstriping, I know we're not in a pinstriping class, but I'm a pinstriper, so we're gonna do some pinstriping. So, like, I tell everybody, you should never do this stuff at first with the intentions of, like, making money. This shit should be like an escape. Like, when you go to your job, you have a stressful day, you come home, go on some good music, and you start pinstriping. Start pinstriping. It should be like a little escape. The next thing you know, you do that over and over, the next thing you know, you're kind of good at it. And the next thing you know, someone's maybe going to want you to do something or buy something from you. It should be an escape. It should be like, it shows, like, customers, like, I have to tell customers all the time, like, if they're getting antsy about their work, I got to tell my man, I'm an artist. Like, if I'm not feeling it one day, like, you're not going to want me to force something down, because at the end of the day, it's not going to be as cool as it could be. It's kind of hard to explain, but probably like a tattoo. Like, say an artist comes, or a customer comes to you and wants to do a tattoo that you're really not into, compared to a tattoo that's like super into, you're going to put way more into one way into.
Exactly.
Yeah, at one point you probably want to get it. I had to do that. That's the way I am with paint workers. Like, if I don't want to do it, I'm like, damn.
That's Gouch. You follow him on Instagram. It's always entertaining. And Adam from Atomic Cycle Designs. This is Tamco Takeover 2, Hampton, Virginia. $300. Get you access to over 15 different classes. This will be an annual event. Here we have the basic airbrush class with Kevin. Over here we see Tim Lowry. If you know Tim's work, he's a phenomenal artist. The birth of a new airbrush artist. Pretty cool. Again, this is Don at Airbrush the Magazine, airbrushthemagazine.com. If you haven't subscribed yet, we'd love to have your support. That's how we get to visit all these airbrush events like Airbrush Circus. We went down and saw Tim in Phoenix at Paint Huffer, and now we're here at Tamco Takeover 2. Here's Kevin teaching some newbies how to airbrush. Pretty cool. Let's see what Tim's painting. I'm
Sounds good.
That's what Tim's class is working on. We'll check back in with Tim later. Again, he's an awesome artist. Let's go see D-Dog and Laying Out Flames. Tamco Takeover. Matt Andrews with the graphics class. Chad Kidder teaching basic airbrushing. Awesome turnout for that class. Awesome to see new people coming in airbrushing. Tamco Takeover 2, Hampton, Virginia, $300. Get you access to over 15 classes over the stretch of this week. I think it's one of the best values in airbrush workshops there is or ever was. $300. Just crazy. Tim Laurie, the list of instructors here, Matt Anderson, D-Dog, Pat. It's just crazy the amount of talent that's here. Sharing their knowledge and techniques. New airbrush class with Kevin. How cool is this? They have three instructors here helping people that are new to airbrushing. Pretty awesome. Matt Andrews with the graphic class doing mini hoods. check in on the pinstriping again. There's Mark, Florida artist.
Second one?
Oh, yeah, this kind of light. That actually, we'll come. Yeah, we do got black paint on it.
Yeah, you can see it. Yeah.
That'll be all right.
Lowrider graphics glass.
This is all part of the process.
John Booth's glass. Working on some skate decks. I mean, here at Tamco Takeover, you could take pinstriping class for 2 days, then come over and take John Booth's class for 2 days. It's all the same fee, $300 flat fee. This year is almost, I think, 15 different classes. John Booth, hard at work. JR in the helmet class. California compressor.
Pick in your pocket.
Right here? What does this win me?
Whatever I want. Chris is going to be doing a live panel. We don't know what it is. I give him
Adam, and John Booth. You having fun?
Yeah. Learn something new.
Cool, cool. We even have the youngsters here. Awesome to see. Awesome event to come to. Dots, lines, dagger strokes. Remember those? We saw Tim in Arizona last weekend. The paint huffer. Let's go check D-Dog out. Flame class. Had to transfer flames from one side to the other. Go back over and check Gaucho. A lot going on here. Good, how are you? Working hard? Having fun?
Second time back.
Good.
Come back every year until there is no more.
Gets a little better every year.
Just do it out here. you want the latex to look? That's so easy.
The laces is pretty much straightforward. Like your full lace pattern, you like. The best place to find this stuff, in my opinion, is like Etsy shop or old grain passed away, and you put it on a tablecloth in the antique shop or something, thrift store.
You want to lace it with black, or you want to put a color in?
I think it's probably black. If I was doing like a big roof on the floor, I was doing a big deal.
Yeah, something like this.
Really, I mean, if you use magnets, stick some magnets down, or like the pressure of your air leaving, I mean, actually pushes it down. Like a fish scale for those laundry bags. Those things look perfect for snake skin. Yeah, put that on, stretch it over, use it as a tool. Yeah, that's what I was just telling them. Like, I'm always skinny.
It's Adam from Atomic Cycle Designs.
Like a really cool look. I want to do like a pearl. I'll spray like a black base paint down first and lace it. And then spray like a pearl, because pearl shows up really good on black. So I'll do a black base coat, lace, and I'll spray a pearl. And the deal, and that kind of gets more of a subtle, not so aggressive. Right there.
It's an awesome class. Gotta let the phone charge. This is Don from Airbrush the Magazine. Airbrushthemagazine.com. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. That's how we can come to all these events like Tamco Takeover, Airbrush Art Circus, Paint Huffer down in Phoenix, and bring you these live events for people subscribing to the magazine. I'll be back with you in a little while. Until then, see ya.